Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Mining Chamber video. In today's video, I'm going to go over Helium Hotspot Miners, as well as the Helium network in general. I will explain it to you so you understand how it works, and I will also tell you everything you need to know before buying the hotspot, so then at the end of this video, it is easier for you to decide if this is a good investment for you. Now let's go ahead and get into it right after the intro. Helium has been a really hot topic the past month due to many awesome influencers creating different content about it, as well as the price action of the HNT token, which is what the hotspot miners get paid with. All this has resulted into many people investing into hotspots without really understanding the Helium network first. So hopefully this video will give you a human-friendly understanding of the network and how everything works from a user to a miner. Now I won't be going into the technical details so that it is easier for you to understand, but if after this video you want another part with diving in depth on how Helium works, then please feel free to let me know in the comments below. So let's first start with the Helium network. The Helium network is made by the hotspot miners that are placed around the globe. These hotspots use a really small amount of your Wi-Fi bandwidth in return of providing long Fi to the network, which is similar to Wi-Fi but it covers a lot more distance. So when these hotspots are placed around the world, it builds the network, also known as the people's network, through the proof of coverage algorithm, a secure, fast, and cheap network that companies and individuals can use for their Internet of Things devices. Now you may wonder, what is Internet of Things devices? IoT devices for sure. In short, Internet of Things can be anything from GPS locators in cars, scooters, and other means of transportation, to sensors and any smart devices that communicate with the internet to be able to send information. Now, the mainstream way that these IoT devices send information is by using cellular network, which is more expensive and requires a lot more work to set up comparing to the Helium network. To be able to use the Helium network, you will have to create a console account with Helium, register your IoT products, and then purchase data credits. Data credits are like mobile minutes that can be purchased for a prepaid phone plans. Only instead of voice data, data credits pay for sensor or device data transferred on the network. When data credits are purchased, some HNT will be burned, causing a deflationary effect, which is always good for the price of the HNT token. Now, as we know with Ethereum, it is a similar concept with what they are implementing on EIP 1559, with burning the fees rather than giving them to the miners, which can also lead to a positive price impact. Now, the only difference is that HNT has a max supply while Ethereum has no max supply. So over time, HNT supply will decrease, causing more scarcity, which in return usually means the price will go up. But still keep in mind that it is cryptocurrency and it can go up or down, which is completely fine. Now back to the network. Your smart devices at home will not be using the Helium network if you have set up a hotspot or if there is one near you, because when you set up your smart doorbell, you most likely connected it to your home Wi-Fi directly rather than the Helium network long Fi, which you'll need to set it up through the user console like I mentioned earlier. As of now, there are many integrations between different IoT cloud platforms with Helium, as well as many companies that are using the Helium network, which is always good to see in a project like this. Hopefully that clarified for you the vision and the goal for the Helium network, also known as the People's Network, and what is the use case for it. Now let's talk about an essential piece of this network, the hotspots. The hotspot miners are tiny little devices that look like an internet router, and they come in different flavors. They draw a really small amount of power, as well as take a small amount of your Wi-Fi bandwidth to be able to supply the long Fi to the Helium network. In return, you get paid in HNT tokens based on multiple different factors, which I will cover later on in the video. So I would highly suggest not rushing into buying them until you get to that part. Now, when the Helium network was still fairly new, anyone was able to make their own hotspot miner at home by using a Raspberry Pi and a specific module, as well as a good antenna. But now you have to get them through the manufacturers that are approved by Helium. You can still make your own at home, but the only thing is that you won't be getting paid at all. Instead, it will just help the network. There can be many reasons for that, but I'm not really sure exactly why, so I wouldn't be able to give you an explanation. So now these manufacturers have different looks, and some are able to be outdoors and while others can only be indoors, but in general they are all very similar and one won't make you more money than the other. Although there is one thing you want to keep an eye on, and it is the frequency. You want to make sure that you get the proper chip frequency for your region, which I will cover later on in the conclusion when I also talk about where I bought mine from. Now the hotspot miner I will be using in this video was sent to me by the team at Helium. It is the original design that is not produced anymore, but the setup process will be identical to the other miners as well. So let's go ahead and jump right into the setup. Setting up the hotspot miner is super simple. unbox your parts, connect the antenna, power plug, and optionally you can connect your Ethernet, but you can also set it up through Wi-Fi. And then after that, you want to go ahead and download the Helium app. Now this app is going to be used to manage all your hotspots if you got more than one, and it's also going to be your wallet for the HNT that you will earn. So do make sure that you save that 12-word seed phrase somewhere safe and never share it with anyone. After you have the app installed and backed up your seed phrase, now you want to go ahead and add the new device, select the manufacturer that you got it from, and then proceed with what shows on the screen. It does not take more than 5 minutes to set it up. The team at Helium made it super simple to get going with this. Your Helium miner will need some time to synchronize, so give it up to 3 days and then check up on it. You will start getting HNT tokens based on how well it does, and that depends on multiple different factors. So before we get into that, let me briefly explain the reward structure. The reward structure can be a bit confusing at first, so I will try my best to clarify it as much as I can. So the first thing you will notice that it is broken into 6 different things. First, you have the proof of coverage challenger, challengees, as well as witnesses, and this is where most of your rewards will come from. How I understood this is that a challenge is just a means for the hotspots to prove their location. The way that the flow goes is that a hotspot would initiate a challenge to a random hotspot in the network once every 240 blocks, which comes out at approximately 2 hours. This hotspot will now be considered a challengee, and it needs to acknowledge the challenge and send information back about its location, proving that it is online and providing coverage. And then the witnesses are the hotspots that are near you. Once they witness the operation, they also get rewarded for it. Same goes if a hotspot near you gets a challenge and your hotspot witnesses it. So it's just a way to maintain the network and make sure that every hotspot is up and running and providing coverage. Now, like I mentioned, this makes up the biggest reward percentage, and it only relies on the location of your hotspot. If you have it in a dead area with not many hotspots around you, then you won't be making much from this at all, which I will cover more in the locations part of this video. And then the next reward is the consensus group. Now for the consensus group selection, after doing some digging, I came out with this summary right here. So it starts with 16 members, and per epoch, 4 new members will be selected while the 12 remain the same, which they end up being replaced in the next 3 epochs. So once 4 epochs are passed, that means all 16 members are changed, because we're changing 4 each epoch. Now, new epochs are generated every 30 blocks, and each block is 30 seconds, so a new epoch is created approximately every 15 minutes. Now, the reward of being selected as a consensus group member is around 45 HNT. Now, this is for the average. Some people might get a lot more, some people might get a lot less. So for example, if we take a look at this site where it shows the different rewards, we can see that in the last 24 hours, some HNT miners made over 200 or 100 HNT. Some of them even almost did 500 HNT, which is a crazy amount of HNT. Which means being selected as a consensus member, it's like basically winning the lottery with HNT miners. Now, the odds of being selected are not so bad. So once I did this calculation, it was around 24,315 active hotspots in the past 30 days. And every hour, it's 8 new members being selected. So if we do the math for this, then you have a probability of being selected once every 127 days. Now, one thing about consensus group selection that it won't be there forever. In August, once their validators go live, these rewards will go to the validators rather than the hotspot miners. So do expect this part to go away later on, which can lead to a 6% drop to the incentives for the hotspot miners. Now, after the consensus group, there is also the security tokens. Now, this can be a little bit misleading, but this is not for the hotspot miners, it's just for the holders and investors of HNT, so don't expect to get paid from that on your hotspot miner. And then finally, you have the network data transfer. The network data transfer is what happens when a user uses the data credits on the Helium network to be able to send some data like we talked about before. So when the companies use the Helium network, you also do get paid from that. Now, this doesn't play a big part in the rewards as of now. So for example, you can see here in the last 24 hours, the data credits resulted in rewards of less than 1 HNT, so it's not that big of an amount at all. But eventually, when more data is being used, the rewards will increase with it. Now, you guys can also notice the percentages here in the HNT distributions. But if you want to find more accurate information, I would definitely come to the sidebot.com and then look at them here. And then you can just calculate the percentage. So if the rewards of HNT were 102,000 in the last 24 hours, then you can see here almost around 70% of that was just through witnesses, and then challenges was almost like 20%, and then the rest of it was less than 10%. So this would be the best way to get accurate and up-to-date information. Now, there are many things that are coming into the network that will change the profits, and one of them being all the HNT miners that are being ordered now, which will be online from June to September, and then also the halving that's coming up on August. I will be talking about that also later on in the video. Now, that wraps it up for the rewards. Now let's go ahead and talk about locations for the HNT miners and give you guys some tips on placing them, as well as how much potentially you'll be making from this miner. understanding your location potential is a crucial step to mining with the hotspots. Now, there are many advanced ways that you can calculate your location profitability based on different factors, but for this video, I will be keeping it simple so you can have a good idea of what you need to know. The main factor is being near other HNT hotspot miners, but also not too close to them. So the ideal distance between you and other hotspots should be around 300 meters, and to visualize that, it will be around 3 football fields. Now, there's another hotspot in your building, that does not mean it's over for you. You can still get rewards, but both of you will get less rewards comparing to just one device per 300 meters. The worst case is when you're alone and then there is no devices near you at all. That will cause your incentives to be very little, and it does not help the Helium network build out through the proof of coverage. So one of your solutions, if you fall under this scenario, is buying at least 2 hotspots and then placing them in someone's house that you trust around you, or convincing your friends to take a look into getting some of the hotspot miners. Now, to get a good idea of how much you will make in your area, go to the Network Explorer and explore hotspots around you and see how much they make daily. You can find all the hotspots that are online here, which also means if you send someone your hotspot name, they will know exactly where that hotspot is located. So do be careful on that side for privacy. Now, just keep in mind that the profitability that you will see on the Explorer, that doesn't mean that it will be guaranteed whenever you get your hotspot as well. There's a lot of things that will change, and I will cover that right after we finish this section. There's also a couple of tips that you can follow to help you achieve maximum coverage and reach to other hotspots. First one is make sure that your hotspot has a good line of sight. Placing your hotspot near a window and avoiding as many walls as possible can help your hotspot reach and witness further devices, which also means the higher the hotspot is placed, the better line of sight it will have. So if you live in an apartment that is on a high floor, then you will be able to reach more hotspots and witness more hotspots. And the second tip would be shopping for a stronger antenna. Now, this is not required, but it's just another way to increase your coverage of your hotspot and reach more hotspots around you. So keeping that in mind, you'll be able to place your hotspot efficiently to maximize your rewards. There are also many tools out there that you can use to get a better location for your hotspot miner, such as CloudRF, which will calculate your line of sight, so feel free to look into these different tools and see which one helps you the most. Also, one thing worth mentioning is that when you decide to transfer your hotspot to a new location, it does come for a small fee of $10, but the process is fairly simple and it can be done through the Helium app. So now that covers everything so far about the Helium hotspot miner and the network in general. So now hopefully you have a good idea of the profitability, the process, and everything in between. So now we can go ahead and talk about the future of Helium, especially for the hotspot miners. Will it always be rewarding as it is now? The number of Helium tokens that are mined yearly are a fixed number, so even if more users come to the Helium network, there will still remain a fixed amount of HNT that will be distributed to all the hotspot miners. Currently, before the halving, 60 million HNT are mined yearly, averaging around 5 million a month. In Sitebot, the numbers show differently due to inconsistency with the data, so do disregard the total rewards that are shown there until it's fixed. So to calculate the estimated profits, we first want to take a look at the hotspots in the network. The HNT hotspots are exponentially increasing, up to 500 devices are being turned on every day. So the profitability generally will only go down when more devices come online. But that does not mean everyone will experience profit loss. Those who live in areas that are not saturated with Helium hotspots, they might experience profit increase if they get a couple of hotspots around them, which will help with the witnesses and everything that deals with rewards. Now, if you live in a saturated area with a lot of hotspots around you, and you get even more hotspots there, then you can expect less profits there. The way we will calculate the profitability is by the total HNT mined a month divided by the total hotspots that are currently online. Like that, we can get a good average of what someone can expect to be making pre-halving, and then we can also get a good estimate of what expected to be making post-halving. So the total HNT mined is 5 million a month, and then we can divide that by 30,000 for the total hotspot miners that are online, which gives us around 166 HNT a month, or an average of 5.5 HNT a day. Current price of HNT is $16.60, so that means a day you can be bringing in around $92, which comes out to almost $3,000 a month. Now, this is just the average, so some people will make less than 2 HNT, while others will make more than 15 HNT based on your location, so it's just a rough estimate for the rewards based on April 29, 2021. And as it seems so far, they don't look bad at all. So what will it look like 2 to 3 months down the line after the halving occurs and a lot more hotspots get online? An email sent out by Helium shows that there were 150k orders of the hotspots at the date of the email was sent. Since then, we can assume that the number most likely climbed up to 200k HNT miners. So the current network is 30k devices, and now we can add the 200k devices that will go online in the couple of the upcoming months, and then we will have the total total of 230k devices. Now, this is just an estimate, it won't be accurate, it might be more or it might be less. The halving will happen in August, approximately in 93 days from this video being posted, which means then the rewards will be cut in half. So instead of 5 million HNT a month that are mined, it will be 2.5 million. Now the 2.5 million divided by the 230k hotspots, that will give us an average of around 10 HNT per month per hotspot. Comparing to the 166 HNT a month, it is definitely a big drop. But also, like before, some will make less than 1 HNT a month, while others can make up to 15 or more HNT a month based on your position and your coverage. But that will be hard to predict. I am sure you're surprised and you think it's not worth it, but there's also good in this. And that is that the HNT token price can definitely go further up. Now, this is just price speculation, but if HNT price goes up to $50 or $100, then making 10 HNT a month is still amazing, especially for the price point of this HNT miner, which is less than $500. Now that basically gives you a look in the future of the potential outcome for the hotspot miners. Now as a conclusion and my plan of action, I think this project is brilliant, not just from the mining aspect of it, but also the network in general. I think it's a great idea and a revolutionary technology that was long overdue. There are also announcements on the 5G network, which is also crazy, especially the fact that us consumers will be able to use it as well with our phones that support 5G. But more on that when they release it. Now what I did was I ordered 5 HNT miners from SP North America. Now the reason that I ordered 5 of them is because I do have 5 locations that I can place these helium hotspots in from friends and family. And the best thing about it is that it's pretty cheap to buy these devices. It's $500 per device. Now I'm not saying $500 is not a lot, but comparing to GPU mining, $500 is basically your power supply. Now I'm still a full on GPU miner, but this is just something nice to have on the side. So the reason that I bought 5 of them from SP North America is because SP North America is run by a friend of mine, Wolf of Bitcoins. He also connected me with Helium for the hotspot that they sent me. The rebrand is powered by Syncrobit, which is one of the official manufacturers for the Helium hotspots. So here on SP North America, you can see the model selection, and since I live in Canada, I selected the first choice, which is the 915Hz, which is compatible with US and Canada. For Europe, you would want to select the 868Hz option. And eventually, SP North America is also adding the 915Hz for Australia, which runs on a different zone from the one on US or Canada. Now, if you don't know what frequency you will be using, I will leave a link in the descriptions below that has a list of different countries and their frequencies. Now, not all of the countries are filled in, but you can just take a look at it and try to figure it out from there. And alternatively, if you don't find your answer there, you can always ask Helium in their Discord server. They're always there to help. Even I myself bombarded them with questions until I got a timeout from their bot. They were super helpful, and I'm sure they will answer your questions. So now if you decide after this video on buying a hotspot miner, feel free to use my link below for SP North America, which will give you 5% off at checkout using the coupon FRIENDS5OFF. You can always feel free to browse the other manufacturers as well. The delivery date will remain similar across all of them. Estimated deliveries are from June to September based on the batch you make it in. Currently, SP North America is on their second batch, which ships in July to August. One thing I recommend avoiding is buying HNT miners from eBay for $5,000 and up. I feel like that is too risky and a lot can just go wrong, so please be careful. And also be very careful of fake distributors. If it's not on the Helium website and approved by them, then just don't buy it. Now that wraps up the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope it answered your questions. If you have any questions or anything that I messed up, please let me know in the comments below. And if you liked the video, make sure to leave a thumbs up, and if you're new here, make sure to subscribe. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.